I'm the oldest of five. Mom and Papa were good to all of us, parked at the docks in the morning and never came back. Mama looked for him and asked around. Some say he was killed. We'll never know. But we were still all right, though. We took in laundry and my brother sold papers. But then Mama died of fever after Gina was born. Then they came for us. I don't know where my three brothers are now, but they promised they'd keep us together. They promised. And I promised Mama that I'd never leave Gina.
All right, children, come off. Quickly now.
Without a word. Single file in front of the train. Now. Hurry. That's it.
Good evening, ladies, sirs. I am Agent Estella Albright, Children's Aid Society. And I have papers on each child's age and background.
George, look! A baby! I want the baby, George!
Ma'am, my wife, she gave birth to a stillborn about a year ago. And we've been wanting to adopt the baby off these trains ever since. This is the first baby we've seen off these trains for a year. We'll take her, ma'am, and we'll raise her like our own.
Her name's Gina. We're sisters.
Where is her mother?
She died in childbirth. We've been at the orphanage for 5 months.
She's so beautiful. Look at her, George. We'll sign the papers and take her home now. George?
But I promised Mama we'd stay together.
Well, please take me too, ma'am. I'll be good. I can cook and I can wash clothes.
George?
Just a moment, sir. Ma'am? I'll take care of this. Not a problem. It happens all the time when the children get separated. Now, Maria, I know this is hard, but you have to listen to them.
But I promised Mama we'd stay together.
Maria, when we found you, all 5 of you, you were living in a storeroom of a sewing factory, full of filth and no food. The baby would be dead if it weren't for us.
Why don't they want me to?
Because their baby died and they want Gina. Now, if you love Gina, do what's best for her. Give her to these good people for them to raise her. Here you are, Mr. and Mrs.
That was the last time I saw my sister. The train went south to Arkansas, and I was adopted by an elderly couple who owned a small farm. They were kind, had no children of their own. And so they adopted me and gave me a wonderful life. But I'd give it all up in a minute just to see my mother's face again. My brothers and sisters, for just one day. I was given a good life, but I never forgot that there was another me, part of my past. That was taken away from me.
August 1914, New York City Orphan Asylum. A train is scheduled to leave the next day for 3 cities in Illinois. The train will be full to make more room in the orphanages.
Why can't they stay at the orphanage? Just so I can. Why can't they stay at the orphanage? I just need to keep them for a few more weeks. Please don't. On the trains.
This is to certify that I am the father and the only legal guardian of Patrick Michael Bird. I hereby freely and against my own will agree for the Children's Aid Society for that home to their age. I promise not to interfere with any arrangements they may make. My lucky Bird.
But I'm trying to tell you, Mr. Clifford, I just need to keep them for a few more weeks. Please don't put them on the train.
Look at you. You've got consumption, sir, and you won't last past Christmas. And I do what's best for your boys. I promise they'll leave your home. Besides, if you left them here, you'd be more to the state. Please sign.
And so Paul signed the papers. He told him not to worry. That even if they did put us on the trains, we'd find a way back to him.
Thank you. Patrick. Write to me any essential. As long as you have this address, you'll always be able to find me.
Patrick, put it. Get on this train now.
No. Hold on to that now. Keep it in a safe place. Not dealing with Patrick and Michael.
My life is Christine Lathie. daughter of Arthur and Clara Lacey, Germantown, Kansas. Even though I'd never been to school, I was behind, I could read. I did well at Germantown High School. Later on, graduated fifth class in 1923. It's below my parents, Arthur and Clara, and my brother and sister, Lester and Maggie. Well, better than I ever hoped for myself things to be. And the orphan trains keep rolling, one every week, out of New York, Boston, and Philadelphia. July 1918, Indiana. An orphan train arrives in Flint Ridge, Indiana.
Get these foreigners' children out of our...